Hey, Deployment Insiders! Today we will do a deep dive into wave customization for the servicing profile. So if you would like to learn more how to create your own customized deployment rings for your office updates, as well as getting some insights into the design and creation process, you're in the right spot. Let's get started.
Everyone, thank you for joining us today. Today we are going to talk about wave customization, how you can configure it, some of the deeper design aspects that you might be interested in to configure your deployments across the organization. And follow us, continue to watch the video. And if you're interested in specific segments, we will also have the timestamps down below.
Thanks, Diksha. You haven't been on the channel before, so can you introduce yourself, your role at Microsoft, and your involvement into wave customization to the audience?
Sure. So I am Diksha. I am the product manager on the Microsoft 365 manageability team, who is responsible for the development of wave customization feature in the Apps Admin Center. And what it means is understanding the customer problem and the space to bring the insights back into the deployment crew and get some feedback from the customers as well. So that's me.
Thanks. So wave customization, wait a minute. When we talk about servicing profiles, there are waves and servicing profiles. So if I set it up to, for example, target my 10,000 devices I have, they are already staggered across typically 4 days after Patch Tuesday. So what is wave customization bringing to the table?
So what wave customization this feature brings to the table is the control that the admins will start having as to which devices fall in which bucket or wave. So prior to wave customization, the admin did not have a control on which devices get assigned to which waves. It was mainly the throttling limits of the tenant which were being respected across those 4 days. Now the admin can consciously call out, hey, these are my early adopters versus these are my relatively risk-averse devices that I want to touch later, and set them up, configure the waves up front.
Okay, sounds good. So instead of talking about this feature the whole time, can we jump in and take a look at it?
Let's jump right in. So how do you configure waves? Well, I'm assuming you already have a servicing profile set up on the Apps Admin Center. So you go right in, log into Apps Admin Center, go to the profile, hit the settings tab, and basically say on the rollout wave column, you say, yes, create the rollout waves. This will enable a bunch of functionality, which will enable you to create new waves. And basically, how do you start configuring? Well, you hit add wave. When you hit add wave, it'll open the flyout, which will allow you to select different Azure AD groups into specific waves. So let's create one right here. Let's say I have a group of early adopters or internal IT admin that I want to be exposed to the update first. So I create that as my wave one. So what I see here now is that there is a second wave that is by default created, which is the catch-all wave. It will contain all the devices in your servicing profile which have not been associated with any of the waves previously. You can also create or customize up to 3 waves. And one important thing to note is you can also, as an IT admin, decide the number of days between the start of each wave. So right now, the option is to distance it out from 1 up to 5 days. So what that means is that the devices in one wave will start getting the updates first, but depending on when the devices check in, the wave might not necessarily 100% be complete before wave 2 starts. But we will have sufficient insights and data as to how the rollout has progressed from the first wave before you jump into the second wave.
So you mentioned you can create 4 waves. So if I select 5 days, so I'm basically the start from Patch Tuesday, the start of all my waves. The last wave will basically start on day 20. So this gives me still enough time to finish my rollout before the next Patch Tuesday hits and we are pushing out the next update. I want to hit on the Azure AD groups real quick because we have some requirements around Azure AD groups. these are very similar to the requirements or the implementation when we're looking at the include feature from servicing profiles. So you can specify Azure AD groups, security groups only, and these can have as members other Azure AD groups, which we resolve up to 3 levels. So you can start nesting groups into each other if this needed. You can add devices as member objects, but then these devices must be either hybrid Azure AD joined or Azure AD joined. Azure AD registered devices are not supported and ignored by the servicing profile. Or you can make this user-based, you can specify user objects, and then this user object is passed into the servicing profile, and we will make the work to translate it into the actual devices which are used by the user, which actually means which M365 app installations were activated by a specific user. And of course, you can start mixing those. So if you want to have a few specific devices in wave one, but then go for a whole department, like for example, your IT department as wave two, which might be easier to target the users instead of the devices, you're absolutely free to mix those.
Thanks, that's a great call out.
All right, so you set up the waves, you hit save. What will happen next?
So, come Patch Tuesday, which is when Microsoft release a new update for the Microsoft 365 applications, your rollout will start falling into place according to the waves. What that means is if you have created, say, 3 waves, wave 1, 2, and 3, space them out by, say, 3 days each. From day 1 to day 3, only the devices with check-in from wave 1 will get the signal to update. Come day 4 is when the next wave will get initiated, and before that, those devices will be completely agnostic to the new update.
Okay, how can I, as an admin, see which devices are on which wave?
Awesome question. So there is a devices tab right here in your profile. So we have added a rollout wave column, which specifies which devices belong to which wave. So this is the information that's available here. There's also a issues tab, which will talk about which issues have been detected in which wave. And, you know, accordingly, the admins can allow the deployment to progress or take action about it.
Okay, so you mentioned the wave starting at Patch Tuesday. Maybe not every admin is kind of setting their clock to wake up exactly on Patch Tuesday and configure wave customization. So if someone is just watching this video and says that's a good idea, they set it up, they hit save, and we are right in the middle of a patch cycle. What will happen then? Will it wait till the next Patch Tuesday, or what will happen?
So here's the thing about this feature. You can go ahead and configure your waves at any point in time in the progress of your rollout. The devices which have already received the update or are in progress of updating will not get impacted by the new configuration at all. The only devices which are yet to receive an update from the previous patch will start behaving in line with the waves.
Mm-hmm.
And come next Patch Tuesday, when a new update is released and it is not available to any of the devices, is when 100% of your devices will be aligned to how the waves are configured.
Yeah, when basically everyone has to go back to square one.
Yes.
And then it starts again.
Yes.
I want to make a call. We mentioned kind of the services creating the waves. So when you go into the admin UI, you can configure everything, hit save. It might take a while, a few hours, or maybe just revisit it next day, until you see the devices on the devices tab to actually show up with the right designation for the different waves. So I know we are all impatient, but it takes some time to do the calculations in the background. Okay, so we have set this up. Everything works fine. Patch Tuesday comes along. My devices are rolling through the different waves. My first wave is nearly done, and help desk is calling me up. Hey, what have you done? I'm hearing there are certain issues. What are my options as an admin if I use wave customization to kind of react if something goes south?
So, well, the hope is that situation won't arrive. You as an IT admin will be ahead of your help desk calls because we have the issue tab. The issues tab basically enumerates any issues detected in the rollout of the first wave, which ideally is hopefully your early adopters. So you can actually see if the devices which have received this update have any bad reaction to it. And the pause and the rollback button are always available to the IT admins. What it means is at any point in the rollout, if you observe issues from the issue tab or get, like you said, help desk calls, you can hit the pause button and the wave will not percolate to any of the other devices. You can also use the rollback button to specifically go back to the last known best version of Microsoft 365 apps.
Very good. Quick shout out, rollback was covered in a different video, so we will put a link there, wherever, or maybe both, we don't know. So we have a dedicated video on how rollback works and how this helps you to kind of get this back to a good known version, and then the devices will basically stay there till the next release is coming along. So I guess we covered the meat and potatoes of wave customization, how you can edit it, or how it works, what is happening in the background, what is the timing of the feature, so what can we expect from an admin perspective. Let's talk a bit more about the creation of the wave customization feature. So you mentioned you're a PM at Microsoft, you were responsible for wave customization. So what was the process after someone throw the idea of wave customization at you?
Yeah, thank you for that question, Martin. So we were hearing some feedback around what is sort of blocking the customers from onboarding servicing profiles. One of the things that came out and loud was wave customization. So what we did was we actually got in touch and worked with some of our largest and most complex customers in order to cover most of our scenarios across all of our customers. We tried to understand the complexities, the risks associated, what are their hesitations in allowing the rollout to progress, and their need for basically safe velocity. So we came back with those requirements, spec'd them out in the tech crew, and we basically coded around it and went back to these customers to get some validation on if this helps their scenarios, which were initially discussed. Well, mostly we received very positive feedback. The customers were excited to be unblocked on, onboarding to servicing profiles. And we are getting the signals that we have been able to reduce the IT admin burden with this feature.
Okay, that's cool to hear that we're able to match what the customer needs and our design principles to kind of find a middle ground where we have a feature which is up in the cloud, easy to set up. Again, it literally takes you a few minutes to set up this feature, and then it will automatically run. It's a red button approach. It will just work every patch Tuesday. So thanks for the insights. I think we covered everything. So thanks for being with us. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Martin, for having me on the channel. Thank you, everyone, for watching us.
Please give us a like and subscribe, and you will get notifications the next time we publish a video. If you have any questions or feedback on the feature that we have discussed, please feel free to leave a comment down below. All right. Till the next time, keep deploying.